Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel. Today will be a short video about the cockpit windows, how to open the sliding window, what to do in case one of them breaks during flight, and what makes them so special. So let's get started.
1383, runway 27, clear to take off. United 1538, runway 27, on its way.
The cockpit of an Airbus A320 has six separate windows. They are set up into two windshields, two sliding windows and two fixed side windows. Now each window is made up out of three Herculite glass layers, which is chemically treated to strengthen and to make it lightweight at the same time. Now all six windows roughly have the same thickness of 1 centimeter, and all of them are heated electrically to prevent them from icing and fogging up. The windshield is the primary window for the pilots to get the best view onto the runway or flight path. And each windshield is fitted with a windscreen wiper. If you want to learn more about the windscreen wipers, look up the video on my channel or just click right here. Now, on the splitter beam between the two windshields sits this little probe, the so-called external visual ice indicator, now, which picks up ice from cold clouds and raindrops, etc., to indicate possible icing on the wings and engine inlets. More about wing and engine anti-icing system in a future video. Now, the electrical heating system works fully automatic, meaning as soon as one engine is running, the heating comes on and stays on throughout the flight. Now, in case your windshield is fully covered in snow and ice, now don't get out your ice scraper or similar tools. Instead, turn on the window heat manually with this button. Other than that, the windshield comes with polarized sun visors, which you can move around and adjust to your needs. Next window is the cockpit sliding window to the left and right of the pilot. Now, the window frame comes with a clip to retain the cable from your headset, a light to illuminate your charts with a switch and dimmer, a cup holder, a retractable sun visor, a paper clip, a pen pocket, a pocket for your EFB, and two control handles. Now, before opening the sliding window, make sure it's clear of any snow and ice, because the window will slide inwards and you don't want melting snow dripping into your compartments and electronics. Remove your headset cable from the retainer to reduce the risk of cable bending. No drinks in the cup holder, and check that nothing is placed on the sliding rail rear of the window. A lot of pilots place yogurts and drinks back here, as the metal is connected to the outer skin of the plane, making it very cold and is therefore misused as a fridge. Then gently pull on the control handle inwards and rearwards to open the window. And as soon as the window unlocks and slides backwards, you'll hear a clicking sound. And that's the locking pin securing the window from moving forward. Once the window is fully open, don't put your hands anywhere near the rail, as it is always covered in grease for smooth operation. To close the window, you flip the locking pin into the aft position, make sure that the rail is clear of any unwanted objects, and then slide the window forwards and use both hands on each handle to push and lock the window in its frame. Make sure that the control handle shows the red ring around the push button, which identifies that the window is closed and locked. If this shouldn't be the case and you take off, the chances are that the window might open upon takeoff, or a possible cabin depressurization could have serious consequences. Now, you physically can't open the window in flight due to the differential cabin pressure, but there is a procedure in case of smoke in the cockpit. Now, you should descend to 10,000 feet to equalize the differential pressure and reduce the speed to 200 knots. And if all previous smoke removal procedures were insufficient, you would then open the pilot monitoring sliding window to suck out the smoke. But I'm not going to go into more detail about this procedure, I'm sorry. But important to know is that the sliding window is the pilot's secondary escape route in case of an evacuation after an unfortunate landing. Primary exit would be through the cockpit door, but in case that's blocked or jammed for some reason, the pilots throw out an escape rope, which is attached above the window, and climb down that rope. Now, the most aft window is the fixed side window. It's also electrically heated and comes with a sun visor, or a curtain you might say, and allows the pilots to get a view onto the airplane wing. Now, you can't see the engine intakes, therefore you would have had to walk back to the cabin window, but this can vary from aircraft to aircraft. Okay, so what happens in case a window gets cracks in mid-air, like in this picture? In case it got damaged by the impact of foreign objects or electrical arcing of the window heating system or other reasons, the first thing is to identify if the crack is either on the cockpit side or on the outer side by using a pen or your fingernail. If it's on the outer side, like shown in this picture, there is not much you can really do. The inner pane is still strong enough to sustain the differential pressure up to the maximum flight level. More or less meaning, fly to your destination airport and then the pilot flying should be on the side of the window which is fully intact. In case both windshields are damaged and the visibility is severely reduced, consider an autoland landing at the next suitable airport. Okay, here's a side note you're not gonna believe. In case autoland is not available and the visibility is so severely reduced on both windows, the pilot flying shall open the side window to get a view onto the runway. This is a procedure, I'm serious. So that puts a visual approach to a whole nother level. In case the window is damaged from the inside of the cockpit, the pilot shall initiate a descent to 23,000 feet to reduce the differential pressure between the cockpit and the outside air pressure down to 5 psi. To reduce the risk of further damage which could lead to a cabin depressurization. I would recommend finding the next suitable airport to land because at lower levels the fuel flow is significantly higher and unexpected turbulence could damage the window even more. But I have to say, cracked windows are a very rare occasion. I've only experienced it once and I admit it looks more frightening than it actually is. Okay, we're just coming to the end of the video, but I have a question for you guys. I have unlocked the function that you can send in and add subtitles to my videos in your language. Now, your work is highly appreciated and your channel name will then be mentioned in the description of the translated video. So thank you very much for your help. I'm really looking forward to that. So that's it for today. Make sure to perform a touch and go out of my Instagram account and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you won't miss out upcoming videos. See you next week. All the best, your Captain Joe.